Greetings and welcome. I wanted to go in on polycystic ovarian syndrome. I started out earlier and just had to jump in this evening, but we on track now, we on track. I am Mama Mawusi Ashakir with the Mothership, and we do education on everything from fertility strategists to doula certifications, lactation consulting, and we support mothers and women wherever they are in their fertility journey. I really wanted to focus in today and really wanted to get us, really get our juices flowing and get us to understanding what we are carrying and how important and how sacred we are. First, before I go into understanding about the disorder, let's talk about the order. Our wombs are designed to literally carry the ovums that become the babies that we carry in our wombs. They're designed to incubate life. When we come into the world, we come into the world with all of the ovums. Our little baby girls have all of the ovums that will eventually become their children. And all of their experiences that they go through in life imprint on their ovaries and imprint on their future children. It's very important that we understand this, because as we're dealing with our children, we're just looking at them like empty vessels, but we're not thinking about the fact that they're carriers of our future. Now, when that young woman becomes of age to menstruate, she then begins to give off, she ovulates and gives off an ovum. That ovum comes from, if you take a look at, I can't point to it, but if you see my uterus right there, you'll be able to see how majestic this uterus looks. Where the ovary sac is, right there, pay attention, where the fallopian tubes are, and then where the body of the uterus is, and then where the cervix is, and where the vagina is. This is where your ovaries are, in that ovarian sac right there. That ovarian sac literally is a storehouse for follicles or ovums that will eventually become mature. The cells of our body are so intelligent that all of the ovums don't come mature at once. All of the ovums are not poured through your fallopian tubes at once. As they come mature, then they are to then come forward out of the ovary, and then move gently through the massage of the fallopian tubes, and then this is a dance of ovulation, which takes about 24 hours and which happens about 14 days after the first day that you start bleeding on a 28-day cycle. Okay. Now, how we get the disorder of PCOS, polycystic ovarian syndrome, is that ovum becomes mature, but it doesn't want to leave the ovary. It doesn't leave the ovary. It just stays. And that happens because our hormones are off. Our hormones are imbalanced. This can happen because, and then oddly, throughout a woman's time of her childbearing years, this may happen to her from time to time, because it can happen during pregnancy, it can happen. The imbalance of hormones happens. You may go to another place, and when you go to another place, environment, let's say like your first day of college, you get to college, it's very different, you're very stressed, something happens, your hormones are off. And you might have a time in which, oh, you have this pain right there at your ovary, right there. Oh, it hurts, but it goes away, and you never have that ever again. But it may also come a time where you keep having it, and it never goes away. Now, that's where it's not normal. That's where it becomes a syndrome, where it doesn't go away. This can happen during, through the early years of puberty. This can happen during the childbearing years of and during pregnancy. This can also happen in the odd hormonal odd time of menopause. So we have to be conscious. And these are normal times that it can happen. But when it becomes a syndrome is when it happens and it stays and it feels the pain is not a coming and going pain, but it's something that hangs around and it hurts really bad. This is something that you'll even find you have acne growth right under here. This is where there's something going on with your ovaries. This is the reflex point for something going on with your ovaries. A woman may find that here, she may get pimples here or even around her mouth before her menstrual cycle. But before her menstrual cycle, she may have pimples here. And this is your ovaries. You may also have, she may also find that the abdominal pain, it really hurts. It really may double her over, or it may be a long ache. I want to show you another uterus too. I'm going to show you where it is in order to show you also when I talk about reflex points, that this is a reflex point for your ovaries. This is also a reflex point for your ovaries and uterus too. And so when we lose our edges, it speaks a lot to our hormonal balance. So a lot of women who are losing their edges or their edges are very fragile, that speaks to that too. So alopecia here, depression and anxiety are also another one of those telltale signs. Really serious mood swings and really serious feelings of anxiety, energy shifts, things like this, tender breasts, because we're dealing with hormones here. Take a look at the diagram here, and you'll see the fallopian tubes and the ovaries there. And this is what an actual uterus would look like in your body. And this is the top of the uterus. And this is how it looks like inside of your body. I love diagrams. But this diagram here, this is what it looks like your ovary as your follicle becomes, as your ovum becomes mature in one side, but on the other side, the next picture below it, so I have one above and then I have another below, that picture that is below is a picture of the polycystic ovary. That means that that ovum didn't want to come out. And so when it didn't want to come out, it wreaked all this havoc in your body, because the ovums also create estrogen in the body. They generate estrogen. So when the hormone levels are off, that's the breasts are tender and the mood swings and the irritation and the acne and the hair is feeling like it's falling out and the depression. This is because the ovaries are not giving off the proper amount of estrogen. The hormonal balance is off. This polycystic ovarian syndrome can also cause miscarriage. You have to be consciously aware of it. And we really need to take a deep look at the foods that we eat. And that's the other thing I wanted to talk about. The different foods that we consume can cause this mishap to happen, can cause these things to, your hormones to be off. And I really want you to be very conscious of that. Be very conscious of dairy products in your diet. Dairy products are very dangerous. They congest our wombs and they can cause infertility. In addition to that, they can cause the hormonal mix-up because most dairy products come from female animals. And so cheese, milk, eggs also including in dairy, even though they're not a milk product, but eggs also chickens and cows are also estrogen carrying beings. So their products that come from them also carry the estrogen that throws off your hormonal balance, that creates the hormonal imbalance with your ovaries that support polycystic ovarian syndrome and create the syndromes that you might have. True, stress is one thing. Stress can happen, and hormonal imbalance can happen from natural issues in life too, but it gets exaggerated from the consumption of foods that are estrogen-based. I want you to really think about that. Some things that we can do to help ourselves are to do a detox, cleanse, sit down, and also cleanse, and also make sure that you're cleansing your bowels, because we always focus just on the uterus, but we're not paying attention to the fact that the bowels sit right behind our uterus. The bowels sit right behind our uterus, and the bowels actually cause our uterus to respond in many different interesting ways. When dairy products impact in our uterus and cause the fecal matter, the skim of the fecal matter, like the fecal impaction or the constipation, some of it leaches into our uterus. And that's what feeds fibroid tumors and also irritates endometriosis and things like this. And even some of the polycystic ovaries can also be irritated if you have endometriosis. I just want you to be conscious of this. Some things that you can do is uterine massage right there at your lower abdomen and down in between your pelvic bones. Good massage there helps. It helps the bowels to move. It helps circulation to the uterus to come in. And when we get good circulation, then we get better hormonal response. Also, like I said, a detox to get all of that impacted fecal matter and congestion out of your organs in your bowels and in your uterus. Also, warm heat packs on your uterus can help with the polycystic ovaries, helping them to get some circulation and get them moving, coming out of the space. Psychologically, our psychology creates our physiology. There's something you're not moving on to. There's something in your life for which you're not moving on to the next level. And what's very important is for you to understand what it is so that you can then move on. The herbs Dung Quai can help with hormonal balance. And then for pain, chamomile, skullcap, and red raspberry. It's very important. I'm giving out some real gems here. Please, if you see this video and you feel it, please share it. Please share it with other sisters that may have this disorder. Share it with them who may need this help. In addition to that, if you would like to learn more about fertility strategies or even womb wellness, please connect with us, because we have a fertility strategist certification program at the Mothership that can support you. And no matter where you are in the world, we serve everybody. We're online. Check us out. And I am Mama Mawusi Ashikir. You can find me on Facebook. Mostly. And you can also find ask anything if you need to ask more about polycystic ovarian syndrome. I am doing consultations, and you can let me know when we can get together and we have some availability. You can connect with that. Many blessings.